Howdy y'all, Bearded Carpenter here. I wanted to let you know that I've started another project that I'll be working on along with the cabin that's back behind me here. It's an old log house, and in the future we'll be sharing some videos with you of what we'll be doing on that cabin. I hope you stay with us. It'll be enjoyable. I'll be working it with this cabin, so I'm going to be kind of bouncing back and forth somewhat. So this week I'm going to be sharing some tool tips with you, some things that I feel like is beneficial in tool care and keeping edges sharp. So I hope you enjoy it. There's a little tip that I would like to give you in caring for your chisels. I keep a really, really sharp edge on all of my edge tools. But when I'm using a chisel and I need to lay it down, see the bevel here? I always turn that to where the bevel is down. And it's the same principle as using a hand plane. I always lay a hand plane over on its side when the blade is out and I've been using it. And that protects the blade. And this also protects the edge. If you turn it with the flat side of your chisel down, if there's any grit or anything there, you're taking a chance on dulling this edge. When you go to the trouble to get the edge on there that I like to have, I like to keep that edge as sharp as I can possibly keep it, because it just makes it so much easier when you're working with hand tools if your tools are really, really sharp. So just a little tip, when you lay your chisel down, always lay it with the bevel down and that edge is up off the surface that you set it on, and it'll help to protect it. There's another tip that I'd like to leave you. I've seen many people set their planes down when they get through. They'll set it right down on the sole of the plane. But if this blade is out and you've been hand planing with it, and unless you bring this blade back every time you set the plane down, you're leaving that contact with whatever you're sitting it on. If there's any dust or grit there, it has a tendency to dull your blade. So whenever I get through using a hand plane, with the blade being out, I always lay it on its side. And that way I don't take a chance on dulling my blade, because it takes a while to get these blades as sharp as I get them. So I try to be careful with them. And also when you're hand planing, and I've seen people do this, they'll drag the plane back with it in contact with the surface that they're planing. And you're just dragging that blade back across that. So what I do is, it's just an unconscious movement. When I go across, I'll pick the back of the plane up to where it's really just touching right in this area here. And then I'll set it back down and come back with it. And that way I'm keeping my blade sharper longer. Something that I wanted to show you when you're using these straps. Can you see how that tightens up on that and gets a bite on it? This part of the strap here is underneath the log, and this part of it is on the top. And as I begin to pick that up, you see how that tightens up? It'll pretty much stay right where it is. And I won't have to worry about that slipping. If I put it the other way, it could slip. But with this, it gets a bite on the log and just works a whole lot better.